Blazkowicz. I need you to make it to the other side of the Great Wall. Look for any kind of opening that will grant you passage to the inside of the wall.
Christ, Captain. Not much sign of civilian life from up here. I hope we're not too late.
Thank you.
Blazkowicz. Head for the old American Bank building. That's where Horton and his group should be holed up. Find them. Persuade them to join our cause.
The American Bank. What's a dollar worth these days? Easy. Can't undo your tragedy, but I can punish the people responsible. shortcut through this building. To the other side. Maybe I can make use of that overhead crane. Overhead crane, up and running.
moving on from the tower now. Mines are disabled. Wyatt is scouting ahead. Just had a big fight with the Nazis. Barely made it. William? Don't know if this is normal, but I think the pregnancy is making me a little, you know, excited. Oh God, is everyone listening in on this frequency?
Yes.
Yes.
Maxos.
Looks like I gotta blast my way out. like someone is putting up a fight.
Take my hand!
You a preacher?
No, this? Lord, Lord, pick these rags up off the streets. Name's Horton.
William J. Blazkowicz.
Blazkowicz? Terror belly hellfire, son. Ain't you supposed to be dead?
I recovered.
Well, terror belly don't mean to be rude, but what's your business around these parts, apart from saving our sorry asses?
I'm with the Chrysal Circle. We're starting a revolution.
Are you now? This here is the last remaining haven for the cancerous growth of independent free thinkers, spreading all over the South and yonder. Oh, we be the outcast, the poor. Well, everyone who ain't part of the American goddamn bourgeois. That man right there, getting himself a drink, that's my old-timer friend, Paris Jack. Paris Jack is a brawler, a cutter, a true-believing anarchist, and a hell of a clarinet player, ain't that right, Paris?
Don't like to toot my own horn, except literally.
Streets are quiet, Horton. Nobody's... Wait. Yes, streets are quiet.
Now that's the professor. She got them eyes, can see a speck of dirt in a cow's ass off 100 yards. I tell you, them goddamn nasty sumbitches coming here, we gonna shoot their asses out, I tell you what. Going out in a blaze of glory, hallelujah!
You got a lot of good people here. You should join us. We could always use more good people.
How you reckon to start this revolution of yours, Terror Billy?
Terror Billy?
Holy shit, it's him.
Didn't that Nazi bitch kill you?
Seems our friend here kind of told St. Pete to go fuck himself.
He's with the Crossell Circle, walking legend.
I know who he is. Oh, damn it. Here they come. Paris, I'm feeling a little jittery. You mind taking the edge off?
Let me see what I can do about that.
You know, my ma always said, never trust a man can't handle his whiskey. So you sit right down, sit there, Billy, and drink up.
Ugh. What in the world the fuck is this shit?
Old Horton special.
God damn.
Now listen, Terry Billy, I respect your ambition. But there's nothing can be done no more. The world has sank into the crapper, and all we can do now is drink this whiskey and watch the vortex suck it all down.
Didn't expect your belly to be quite so yellow.
We've been fighting for a revolution since long before them Nazis came here. We were the first to start building a civil rights movement to advocate equality for everyone. You know the concept of civil rights, Terry Billy? No, you don't. You're just a jarhead, ain't you?
Buddy, I laid my life on the line for freedom, justice, and the American way while you and your bohemian friends were passing out Bolshevik propaganda and opposing the draft on every street corner. What good is your fucking equality? You can't muster the backbone to stick up for your people while the coyote's scratching at your front door.
We stood up against the imperialist war machine in the United States of America and the greedy money men of Wall Street. It was itching to send the children of the proletariat off to die in foreign lands so that they could be filling their coffers. It weren't their sons bleeding on the beaches. No, they draft people like you for their dirty work while they was watching the dollars roll in. You're the pawn, the passive, the takers, men in marble mansions. Well, I see through that shit. Decided not to be a party to it.
And yet here you are, guns in hand, shooting Nazis, just like me. Difference is you come late to the party. Perhaps your kind had gotten their asses in gear, we'd have won the war.
Don't spill that shit on the table, Horton, and leave right through it.
This'll get you drunk, Terry Billy. You upstanding lackey of the establishment, Jake.
Listen, pal, I ain't got time for your horse shit. You gotta make the call. Give up and die or step the fuck up.
I ain't wanting to argue with you, Terry Billy. You're too tired to fight.
You tired? Man, fuck you. I got kids on the way. And I'll be damned if I'm gonna raise them in a world run by these Nazi assholes. So what's it gonna be, you hillbilly, degenerate moonshiner, Bolshevik cowards, goddamn traitors?
Lord, Lord, I ain't never seen a man remain coherent after more than one shot over Horton special. I like you, Billy. Like your gumption. All right. Let's start this revolution. Hit it! Paris been working on this puppy for over a month now.
Hot damn. How'd you tame it?
Popped the hood, pulled some wires, that about it.
He's a quick learner, Paris. Always figures out what's what.
So, what's your plan?
You're gonna ride it, cowboy. Yes, sir. You're gonna ride on out there, draw off a Nazi fire while we make our way down to the harbor with all those who survived the purge.
Gotcha.
All hinges on that boat of yours showing up.
It'll be there.
Oh, easy now, easy. There you go. Just mind the temper.
Here. Nazis swarming in like flies on shit.
Check, check. All set, Terror Billy. Now get!
See what this puppy can do.
Anya. Come in, Anya. Do you read?
William, I read you.
What's happened? You okay there, darling?
I'm doing... fine. I'm trying to regroup with Dwight. I've contacted Grace. The U-boat is on its way in, and we are on our way to Lakeview District.
Listen, don't do anything reckless. You stay safe.
I'll be fine. Anya out.
Horton, what's your status?
Rounding up the last of the people and fixing to leave.
Make your way to the Lakeview District. Bring everyone. We're getting a ride out of here.
Well, Billy, that might be a fine idea in theory, but I reckon all them Nazis between here and yonder might slow us down, dearly.
Wager I can get their attention.
Next stop, Lakeview District.
Here. We're standing on top of the Lakeview apartment building. So many of them. They just keep coming. So many Nazis. It never ends, does it, Captain? Can you dig it, man? Wyatt, out.
Terrabilly, we've met up with your people on the roof of the Lakeview apartment building. That ride of yours better get here soon, because we won't hold out much longer.
Boss man, come in. Where's our boat? I don't see no boat! We're getting our butts handed to us out here!
Wyatt, I read. Sorry, we're being held up. Working to resolve the problem.
This is it, Anya! This is where it all ends!
Grace! We need evacuation now!
I knew you would make it!
Wyatt, Anya, help everyone get on board the U-boat. The Nazis will regroup and attack. Hurry up! Laskowitz, get your ass up on the Lakeview apartment building roof and climb on board the U-boat. We've spotted the Altmercer on the radar. It'll be here any minute. Haul ass! Laskowitz, all of the evacuees are on board, but we can't leave. Props are stuck in the mud. We're stranded, and the Altmercer is incoming. If it gets here before we bail, we are fucked.
What about, like, the nuclear cannon?
What are you talking about, Wyatt?
The shockwave from the nuke could push us out to sea, man.
Now that's the stupidest fucking plan I have ever heard. Set.
Well, for every action, there's an equal and opposite reaction.
Laskowitz, hop on the nuclear cannon and fire it to maximum distance. I just hope it's far enough away from us not to rupture the hull.
You have to fire now, Blaskowitz! Now!
Looks like the Altmercer lost track of us. Clear skies on the scope.
Fryer Engel commands it now, using it to hunt terrorists. But in the way back, the Altmercer would roam from city to city, crushing any resistance. Now, if we ignite a revolt, you can be sure the Altmercer swoop in, put an end to it, break and say hell's bells. If we're gonna start this revolution, we need to put an end to the Altmercer firstly.
So then we mount a surprise attack, conquer the Altmercer and use it against the Nazis.
Well, the Altmercer is protected by an automated security system called Odin. Seen it when I was up there.
We'll hijack the system, find the Odin codes, and disable the fucking thing. Yeah, but that kind of information is a top military secret. Only the Oberkommando is privy to it.
It's so easy, man. I've got it all figured out.
Oh, yeah?
After you atom-bombed the bejesus out of the old Oberkommando at Roswell, the Nazis ran scared. They took all their top brass, all their top military secrets, and they reestablished the Oberkommando on Venus. Venus, the planetary body, Venus in space, man. It is cold. Up there, you're gonna need radioactive mittens.
Mittens, nigga!
Okay, we're just gonna fly there. We are gonna load up, and we're gonna fly.
Uh-huh.
Oh, man, we're just gonna take our choppers, but instead of only going so high, we are just gonna keep going straight up right into space with the mind, you know? Then we're gonna drop you off on Venus. You're gonna break into the Oberkommando, and you are gonna steal those Odin secrets from their computing machines.
So, I might have a plan too? Wyatt, do you mind?
No, man. It's all good.
In 2 days, final auditions for the role of the infamous terrorist William Terror Billy Glaskowitz take place on the enigmatic Aristat habitat on Venus. One of the hopeful actors is Jules Redfield, here getting a snack from his favorite milkshake bar in his hometown.
I knew what you think.
William and I are going for milkshakes. His papers are all in his glove box.
Yeah. What about him?
Well, is he a Nazi?
You a Nazi fella?
Can't even tell no more. How I look?
Like a walrus. Don't forget your luggage. Remember, you're a Jules Redfield, professional actor, traveling to Venus to audition for the part of William Joseph Blazkowicz. Now, you are summoned by personal invitation, so security should be minimal. Break a leg.
Mr. Redfield? Mr. Hughes Redfield?
Yeah, that's me.
I'm Helena, the director of this film. Apologies for the long journey, but my producer favors a safe location and has an affinity for dramatic settings. Come.
My luggage.
Someone will bring it for you. Come. Welcome to the audition, Mr. Redfield.